The decision by government to put more effort on the export of skilled labor rather than maids comes in the wake of complaints of mistreatment of Ugandans working especially in the United Arab Emirates. The government is now considering skilled labor such as doctors, nurses, builders and drivers.
I'm trying to work out a way of getting skilled laborers, and I'm working out with some other countries. I can't bring it out now. But this is what I'm doing, trying to do, so that we move away from this domestic issues. I think we have so many nurses here who are trained, we have doctors, we have, you know, drivers, and there are countries who want drivers, there are countries who want nurses, there are countries who want, and they're there. And we have nurses here, we are not working. We have drivers, we have doctors, we have builders. Actually, I was talking with some, with a country, we need a lot of builders. So I think that is the side we are moving to create jobs for those skilled workers.
The ambassador of Uganda to the United Arab Emirates, Zake Chibedi, told journalists that the repatriation exercise of Ugandans stranded in the United Arab Emirates, which commenced early August, is still ongoing. So far, over 1,000 Ugandans have been repatriated. Others have been advised to report to the immigration camps within their areas of residence before the expiry of the amnesty at the end of this month.
1,500 Ugandans, 280. Had their passports and they were immediately repatriated that the first week of August. The 1,220 who did not have passports, the embassy of Uganda to the United Arab Emirates sought permission from the Ministry of Internal Affairs, Department of Immigration, to issue the requisite travel documents, which are known as certificates of identity on gratis. Upon authorization, we issued all the remaining 1,220 Ugandans that did not have passports with certificates of identity. On Sunday, 23rd October 2022, majority of the Ugandans that were still at Alwil immigration camp had been repatriated aboard Fly Dubai and Air Arabia. And the last batch arrived on Monday this week, October 24th, 2022. As we talk now, there is no Ugandan who is still stranded at Alwil deportation camp.
It is estimated that out of the over 100,000 Ugandans living and working in the United Arab Emirates, only 5% are there legally.
The areas we have now penciled in are those areas that touch the rights of our people. Of course, the other area we want to strengthen is the monitoring. And by monitoring, it is not a one-off. That monitoring should be continuous throughout the whole process. And the monitoring does not start when the migrant worker gets across to the destination country. The monitoring starts here so that we can account for every Ugandan who travels outside this country.
Story by Jaliet Namoya for the news.